Let's do a Pikachu.
Pikachu is great.
Oh, yes.
We'll do a Pikachu. Somebody did say Pikachu earlier.
Yeah.
All right, let's see like if we can... oh, my God. Ian, can you blow up the his screen share on our monitors?
Of course.
That would be great. Oh, perfect.
Is that better?
Yes, that's
perfect.
Should
I move the text over? Is it okay?
No, no. I think it's fine.
Okay, cool.
We're just...
By the way, yeah, if you're drawing along at home... Send it to submissions.rollingstone@gmail.com. We'll show them at the end of the stream. Please don't send us anything disgusting. Okay? Chris, our poor producer Chris, is going to have to be looking at him, and he wants to start his weekend off right. So please be respectful.
Don't traumatize
him. I got to freaking draw a Pikachu. What's that?
For reference?
Oh, I know what Pikachu looks like, Tia.
No, I know, but I just can't just free, you know, just, I need to look at him.
I got this by memory.
Mike, do you have a reference for Pikachu? Or are you just going?
I am cheating a little bit. I am looking at a reference.
Okay, looking at a reference.
You guys are allowed to have a reference.
All right, okay, I'll go a reference for this.
The live action Pikachu is the cutest thing, where he's wearing that little hat.
Oh my God, a Detective Pikachu?
Yes.
Oh my God. Oh, send me to heaven.
I'm going to do a little bit of a like a thing, and then I'm going to come back and fill it in a little bit.
All of these special pens.
Oh wow. Oh Lord. Yeah, we went to Muji today. Got all these pens. Got a calligraphy pen.
On the iPad, because it's a little more like
Wow, you're already off to a great... I already had to start on a new page again because okay.
Do you usually draw all of your things digitally, Mike? Or do you ever do like a straight up canvas?
Lately I've been drawing digitally. What's nice about it is, like, so let's say with this guy, I go, oh man, he's really like, he's too like, oh, this body is too big or whatever. Then I can just kind of go in and grab just the body and shrink it.
Oh yeah. Yeah. It's a lot easier that way. Because then you get like a full... Oh my God, I think you're drawing the same reference photo I'm drawing.
Wait.
I'm like, that hand motion looks very familiar.
Here,
oh goodness.
Oh my God.
I am...
Wow, I have to be so careful.
Oh, right. And you're doing left hand.
Oh yeah. This is going to be very interesting.
You know, I feel like even with a reference photo, somehow this is going to be very demented, but...
Are we doing another one, or is this the one?
Oh yeah, we'll do some more.
Yeah,
I'm sure we'll have some time for some more.
Ooh, yeah, mine is looking rough. But
oh boy,
let's turn him a little bit. Let's...
Okay, let's see.
Yeah, we need an original for our studio.
That's right.
So I don't
exactly.
We have to think of a suggestion that isn't too IP driven.
Hey, John, that looks pretty good. Chat, you can't see it, but. You.
I'll show it at the end. Oh, you're giving him a little hat too. Oh, that's cute.
Oh wow. Meanwhile, I'm still trying to outline the body.
You'll get it, Tia. The chat was saying "Booty Down" was the weirdest song you've made so far. Down.
"Booty Down" was basically the story behind that. So I made this. I was supposed to make this "Panic of the Disco" track. Is what they wanted me to do. "Panic of the Disco," and it was a disaster. So dumb. And I gave up at the end of it, and then started like scrolling through like sounds that were on my like in my library, and I found whenever you buy a pack of sounds, I should say most times if you buy like an expansion pack of sounds, there will be like these vocal stabs, like these vocal samples. And they're like some, if it's a hip hop expansion pack, like there'll be all these like dumb hip hop ones where they're like yo,
generic.
And like,
yeah.
That's fire. And then they're the worst. They're 100%.
Oh my God, that's amazing.
And so I was doing that, like playing them, and the chat was like, you know, everybody was laughing. And I hit this one section where there was like booty up.
Wait, that is so funny.
Booty up.
Sampled those. I used them and like made this god awful song, which
oh my
is
god,
one of our favorites.
That's great.
That is amazing. I also love picturing who had to go into the studio to record that.
Yeah, there's just like a guy all serious.
And they
like
made
in
him
the
do
booth.
Like 10 takes of it too because he didn't get it the first time.
A little more punch on the
and there's
on a, the booty.
There's just like, one like booty up guy, and then the other guy's a booty down guy. Like, no, sorry, I only work in booty down. I'm no booty up.
Yeah, I don't do booty up.
Wow, look at that shading. Oh my
wow. Goodness. Oh my God. That's looking pretty good, Mike, over there. Oh man. Okay. I'm going like so slow because I just can't draw lines.
I'm over here flaunting my la 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 la, going in my dominant hand.
I kind of want to, I'm going to take a little sneak peek at yours, John, just because I'm curious.
Yeah, come on here. Check it out.
The way your voice cracked, you're like, sure.
Yeah, come on here and check it out.
Oh, John. It's so like.
It's not bad.
It's not bad. It's you're getting the outline well. It's just so shaky. Tia's doing color.
Yeah, wow. Oh, it's got some color going
buy
on here.
Those color markers.
Oh, are we doing color?
Tia's jumping into the color.
I just had the time. Mine is a little deformed, so I just wanted to give him a pop.
A little deformed.
Pop of color.
Exactly. One
color. John's is.
What movie is that from?
Pop of color?
Yeah.
What movie is that from?
Oh, man. You know, John and I are terrible at movie references, so.
Are you getting the quiz music right now?
Can we get a hint?
Oh my God.
Nathan Lane.
Wait, I have a question for you. Have you seen The Blues Brothers?
That's the one movie.
Have I?
Yeah, have you?
I think so. I don't know. Maybe I haven't, actually.
With Dan Aykroyd and John Belushi, that's the one movie I watch over and over again. So.
Why have I not seen The Blues Brothers? That's really weird. I've not seen it.
You should watch it. Came out in, 1980?
Is that your favorite movie, too?
It's my favorite movie of all time, yeah. I've seen it well over 100 times, like every great film.
Well, all right, Mike. You're 1 for 2, but have you seen Tenacious D in The Pick of Destiny, my favorite movie?
Not really your favorite movie?
He's like, I am never coming back here.
Statistically, I think it is my favorite movie because I've seen it just so many times that I don't think anything could beat it for me.
Is your second favorite movie Hot Tub Time Machine?
How did you know?
Hot Tub Time Machine 2.
Yeah, right. I'm a man of class.
Oh my goodness. Wait, Mike, what are yours? What are your top three favorite movies?
I don't really have a list. I mean, I've always loved, let's see, what movies do I love? I love, The Godfather. I loved Godfather 2, actually. I loved The Shining.
Oh,
so
yeah.
Super dark, but it was just amazing. What else? I loved Chat. We did this on the channel. Like, what did I name? I named kinds of.
Someone said Back to the Future. Love Back to the Future.
Sharknado. Thank you, chat. Yes.
Sharknado. Oh my God. Which one? Three? There's so many.
I can't be held to one.
If you, Mike.
Out of the 9 Fast and Furious films, can you rank your favorite?
Oh my God. I've never seen a Fast and Furious film.
Neither have I.
Yeah, I haven't.
I've only seen the first one.
Is that right? XXX is Vin Diesel, right?
Yeah. Triple X. It is great soundtrack in that movie. Mushroom Heads on there. It's some good stuff.
That's like a real thing. They have a soundtrack?
Yeah. It's a spectacular soundtrack. I haven't seen the movie, but I've listened to the soundtrack many a time.
I love when a movie has a good soundtrack.
Talking about Sharknado, Mike, have you ever seen Mega Shark versus Giant Octopus?
Sounds like something that I should see.
Oh yeah, definitely. It's a sci-fi original, so it's got the goods.
Wow, wait, that is an amazing drawing. Wow.
Oh my God, that's beautiful.
Okay, your color compared to the color that I will be showing on camera will be very different.
Well,
but
Tia, you're working with what you have.
Yeah, that is true. Okay,
I'll just do this. Quick scribble. Wait, we're gonna do another one of these. Let's maybe we should move on.
Yeah.
you're gonna really get into the weeds. We could do one more.
All right, so let's
one or two, depending on timing.
Yeah.
Okay. So John, well, actually Tia, you show yours first.
All right, everyone.
That's so cute.
Here he is.
Wow, that's quite adorable.
That's really good.
Thank
I like
you
it.
So much. Thank you. From afar, he's really doing his thing. He's cute. He's fun. He's young.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I'll show mine now. Oh, got the music for it.
Jon with his left hand, mind
you. My left hand. That's my left-handed Pikachu.
There he is. There's the Pikachu.
There he is.
It's not bad.
It's something like a Pikachu.
It's not bad.
Yeah, sure.
Like, get my like last minute coloring in here. I know that
yours
we've got
looks
it.
Amazing. Also, the fact that his mouth is shaded, there's you can
yeah,
tell
wow.
the distinct difference
the
between the tongue and the rest of the mouth.
Really nice too. I like the turquoise hat. I I was just very shaky on this one.
Someone said that's good for your non-dominant hand.
Oh, thank
yes,
you.
It is.
It's the only part was like I tried to get the little white in the eyes, but I couldn't do it. So I fully colored in the eyes black, so he looks like he's just like a satanic Pikachu, more like.
Just like you like him.
Or like he got possessed in Supernatural
yeah,
or something.
Everyone said it's decent. Mike, yours looks like, is he on us? Oh.
Look at that.
With oh, it's got, is that a surfboard?
Little shadow. He's on a little shadow.
Oh my god.
Oh my goodness.
Like in a Pokemon battle. He's got the little like little
this
circle around him.
No, he's so saying, cute. He's out on the grass getting ready for his battle.
He's got an environment.
Oh wow, I love it.
Look at that. Ours were floating in the void.
Oh, I forgot the tail.
He's got it tucked behind him. It's okay.
Yeah, it's tucked.
And then okay. Here we have our hold on 1 second. Sorry. Our producer, Yo Chris Cruz.
Oh, did we already get some submissions?
It was, no, just Chris drew one. So this is what he drew. I don't know what's going on there, Chris.
You're running through. He's
everything
running
okay
through
with you, bud?
Things.
Look at that thing.
It looks like a looks like a Keith Haring Pikachu.
That Pikachu's kind of pissed. Like
yeah.
He's kind of
yeah,
He's ready to go.
Chris is working through some things on a Friday afternoon.
Someone said that, Jon, you draw your Pikachu with your offhand better than they could draw a stick figure with their dominant hand.
Wow,
so.
Thank you. Oh, that's so nice, Justin.
And Mike, yours looks amazing with the grass. I guess we have...
Yeah, well, I love the grass.
We got
about
like 10
minutes,
round.
So yeah, we have about 10 minutes or so.
Yeah, we can make another one. If
one
chat wants to suggest another drawing or another subject that we could draw...
Let's go.
Yeah, chat, let us know what you want us to draw next.
Are many. Some are mad. That's an angry Pikachu. Yes. Elephant, penguin. I'm just reading the chat. Yeah. Elephant, penguin, pineapple, wombat, jellyfish.
Sushi, Brockhampton.
Brockhampton, we'd be here all day.
Let's draw Brockhampton.
All members of Brockhampton. All right.
Mine are all going to be
great.
Stick figures. Okay.
Great, great, great. Oh my god, drawing people is like...
I know, that
something
is like
I
the
cannot
thing
do.
We kind of need some more emotes. Okay, so is there an emote idea that we could do?
I don't know.
What do you find yourself needing to say or...
No, I'm down with Brockhampton if Mike is. It's up to you.
Oh, there's like people in Brockhampton.
No, I can't do it.
I mean, you were confident before. I was going to go with it.
I honestly, that would be like horrible.
Should we do a Tia or Jon Pog face? Poggers? So when like something's really exciting.
Oh, like
they're spamming the chat with my Pog.
Yeah, I think we need our own Pog.
Yeah, I mean,
we do have Jon backflipping, but I think we need and we do have Tia with her nausea band.
Yeah. I mean, if you see anything in the chat, Mike, that calls out to you. Oh, someone said SpongeBob.
Sushi for some reason. Like a sushi?
Like sushi? A roll?
Like it could be any kind of sushi, but ooh. You have to turn it into a character.
Oh, okay. So like with a little face on it.
Eyes, at least.
Yeah.
Oh,
okay. Like a cute little sushi character.
I like that.
All right. Okay.
Yeah.
That sounds good. Hmm. Let's get into it.
Okay.
Horror sushi we got in the chat. That's an interesting one. Maybe I'll consider doing something like that.
Like what you get at the end of the day at the 7-Eleven when you get the sushi there.
Ooh, let's see what I can do with this sushi. Okay.
Yeah. Ooh, goodness. Okay. I'm already.
You know, Ian,
you
rag on 7-Eleven sushi, but I'll tell you what. In Japan, the 7-Eleven sushi is quite amazing.
That is, I've heard great things about 7-Eleven.
It's real good. Oh, the Japanese 7-Eleven is the absolute best. You got the karaage fresh. So good.
I have never been, so I can't comment.
Oh.
So I was discussing American.
Already have to go to my next page. Starting off
already
a little
messed up. Yeah, I think I've already
too overconfident with. Okay.
Okay. Wait a second.
I know exactly. I have a vision. I just need to.
Okay.
Also, chat, if you're submitting your photos to our email, add your username to your picture so we don't have to read off your government name on the screen.
Tia's big on privacy.
I am big on privacy.
I thought you were going to say Tia's big on government names. She loves the government name.
Who's Smurry said, Mike, that you're drawing Jacko Sushi?
Jacko Sushi?
Like a jack-o'-lantern.
Oh, wow. Wait a minute. I just looked up for the first time. It looks great.
Wow. That looks amazing. Okay. I am drawing something totally different.
Well, I think that's the idea.
That's the beauty of doing like this type of thing. Like such a random, theme is that we're all going to be drawing completely different things.
Okay.
Let's see. Oh, nice.
While you guys draw, I might indulge the chat and Mike in a fun kind of Linkin Park story that I had growing up. In high school, we had a Chinese exchange student stay with us. His name was Bing Hua, and he was like such a sweet kid. And on the last day, we went and did karaoke. All the Chinese exchange students and all the kids from my high school went and did karaoke together. And I grew up in Virginia, which is, really diverse. So the karaoke place had all these Chinese songs. They had all these English songs. They had all these Thai songs, whatever, wherever you're from. And so all the Chinese exchange students were singing songs in Chinese, and all the American students, we were singing songs in English. So I asked Bing Hua if he knew any American bands, any American music, and he looked at me and he goes, "I love Linkin Park." So then the rest of the night we just sang, me and him just sang all the Linkin Park songs that they had at the karaoke place.
That's
it was like
amazing.
The one thing that bridged our parties together. It was
the Linkin Park fan base in China is spectacular. Like it's so interesting, and they one of the things that's so remarkable is that we did, like, the last time we toured there, we had a run of five shows that when they put them on sale, our promoter for the shows was like, he chose the places and helped us like navigate the whole thing, and the other promoters were like, other Chinese promoters were like, "You're crazy. Like this, the two of the five cities that you're playing in, they don't speak any English at all. Like Western bands can't, you're not going to be able to sell those shows." And they were the first two that sold out.
Wow.
Wow. Oh my God.
What had happened to set that up, which I'm not sure if the other promoters knew, is that the one of our previous shows, when we got there on the ground, so this is a separate, this was years and years before. When we got on the ground off of our flight, the promoter's assistant picked us up at the airport. And she was like, she had said in the car, she's like, "Do you know what a big deal this show is?" We were playing Shanghai Stadium.
Wow.
And she's like, "Do you know what a big deal this is?" We're like, "Yeah, it's a really big venue," we heard. She's like, "Well, no, yes, but Western bands don't usually, like, not only do they not usually play this venue, but the last two bands that we had here were the Rolling Stones." One date was the Rolling Stones, another date was Nine Inch Nails.
Wow.
And she's like, "They played at this other venue, which is 12,000 seats. Your venue is 37,000 seats."
Wow. Like,
oh my God.
Oh my God. It's like not even, it's not even close. And she's like, "No, English speaking bands can't play these venues, but you guys are just so well known in China." And, we had done, tried to do our homework about it and make sure that we really gave the Chinese fans a good time. The federal police are there, like, on site at all of these things to make sure that, you know, no bad things happen and that people are behaving appropriately. And they were on site for our show, and they were very intimidating for us and for everybody else. And the guy, basically, the when we started the show, they were all standing with their arms crossed. They had, you know, not like, well, some, I think some of the police in the venue had like guns and stuff, but most of them had batons and other things like that. And when the show started, we knew that if anybody acted up, they were gonna, they could potentially just shut the whole thing down. And by acting up, I mean standing up and jumping too much. Like, wow. That, you weren't allowed to do that. So in the beginning, they had most of the people sitting. But when the show started, people started to stand up, and you could tell the police got uncomfortable. And we were like, oh God, this whole thing's gonna get shut down. And after a few minutes, they realized, like, the police themselves realized, oh, this show is there. It's loud and it's like aggressive sounding, but nobody's here to like screw it up. Like, nobody's here to have a bad time. And the band is just like, they're letting out all this energy, not like causing it, like creating it. And you started to see the police, like the staff and the police people in the front rows, you started to see them kind of like bobbing to the music, and we knew we were fine. That's like, they great. Was four songs in, they started to like lighten up and enjoy themselves, and for the rest of the night it was just like magical. Like, people were just
so amazing,
best time. It was special.
How do you even like process after the fact, going out in front of 36,000 people and performing? Like, how do you stay in that moment so it's not just like some adrenaline rush that you don't even remember? Or is it?
Well, I mean, I think, like, having done that for so long, you know, you first of all, you have to, like, we always were very good as a group to, like, almost like keep each other in check to a degree. Like, if anybody started acting like it wasn't a big deal, and it's like, whatever, you know, it's whatever to be playing this huge show or be, I don't know what, like winning another MTV award or whatever. Mm-hmm. Like if anybody treated it that way and acted that way, like, the other guys would be, we make fun of you so quickly and just keep each other in check. So I think that's part of it.
That's great. Just like, keeping each other in check. Your drawing looks amazing, by the way. This sushi is great. And I know we, you know, are running out of time here. So if you're ready, well, I know.
Yep.
Well, this is my, Tia, do you want to show yours off?
This looks great. I was going to let Mike start off. Show us what he's done.
The audience finished. Has been seeing.
Yeah, they've
been seeing. So
what is the brown thing under the mouth?
He needed something to show, to like accentuate his lip.
I like his little.
I like that.
I like his little gloves.
Yeah, my shoes.
Oops, hold on. How do I erase this? So if I take it off, like, his mouth kind of. Do you see how his mouth
just kind of drops off? Subtle details.
Actually, another way to do that might be to kind of extend this bit here and like do like that. So that would help maybe. But yeah,
I loved it. I just wanted to ask. I thought it looked great.
And maybe like a little tiny bit like this. Like, it's a little there.
Yeah, nice little lip accentuation. I know, John, you're coming.
Shinoda Soda says he needs a soy sauce puddle.
That's great.
To stand in.
Yeah, he did start off evil. Now he's cute. This one is mine, chat. Much smaller.
The drum roll. Let's set it up. Oh, that's so cute.
You know.
Oh, I got holding chopsticks. Looks like he's going to go on like a little boat trip. something like is going to exactly. like paddle himself to safety from
paddle himself
human mouths.
The soy sauce. John, you can hold your safety. Thank you, Chad. I appreciate it.
Okay. All right. This is my little sushi.
Drawn with his non-dominant hand.
With my non-dominant hand, of course.
Yes!
Wait, put it in front of your face directly.
Yeah.
Cool.
So,
the shoes.
Wait, let me go to the, hold on one second.
Yeah, he got some green shoes. He's got the salmon up top laying across.
This is making me so hungry.
He looks kind of angry. I didn't mean him for him to be so angry, but he's looking kind of angry.
John, that's actually really good. That really looks like great sushi.
Thanks. Oh, I really appreciate it.
And Tia, can I see yours again? Yeah. Sorry, I didn't really get a chance to see yours. Oh, yours is really cute.
That's how he's looking. He's a fun guy.
Fun guy.
He's very cute.
And my guy's, it's for the chat that was asking. Yeah, he's got a speech bubble. It says, "What's up, B?"
So. And then,
this has been so fun. Oh, my goodness. And chat was loving it, too.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
This is great. Well, Mike, thank you so much for coming on the stream and drawing with us.
You're welcome. It was fun.
Yeah, we would love to have you back sometime.
It would be great.
I feel like awesome. We barely brushed the surface, but we'd love to have you back for longer, please.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah,
it's awesome.
Thanks for coming. Please feel free to send us those photos, too, so we can hang them up in the studio.
I will send you these. Oh, fantastic. The chat always makes me sign. Hold on.
Yes. Oh, nice. Yes, the signature is good.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh. The wasabi in the corner.
Oh, my God. So cute.
I have to sign this here. And then...
Oh, that is a great signature.
Yeah.
Every time I sign a check or something, I'm like, oh, come on.
They've laughed at terrible. Me at the MTA before. Love the Pikachu one.
You just got to practice it, John.
Yeah, I know.
You'll get it.
Oh, there it is.
Wow.
A Mike Shinoda original.
This is great.
All right, guys.
These are great. Yeah.
All right. Well, Mike, thank you so much for joining our stream today and hope to have you back real soon.
Yeah. Thanks again.
Yes.
Bye.
Thanks. Bye.
What a buy in unison.
I know. Really yeah. Cute. What yes. a great time.
Oh, wow. Look at this wide angle we got going on.
Yeah. Right very,
I had
very
to show
wide.
You both yeah. drawing.
Really yeah. cool. We got our like robot arms over here.
Yeah. Well, chat. I know we got a ton of submissions.
We have
from
so many submissions and they all look amazing.
Yeah.
Everybody. We want to cycle through some of them right now. Oh my God. Look at this.
Oh my goodness.
Wow. Fat Pikachu. It's not that fat, but oh my God. Adorable. I have a little tooth sticking out the top.
I got it.
So cute.
Hold on. I'm going to figure out a better way so I have them all ready so we can just like go through all of them and I'm not like clicking back and forth too much.
Yeah.
Just
yeah,
give
cool.
me a quick set.
I'm glad you all enjoyed the stream
yeah.
as well.
Everybody was so active, so involved. Honestly. So we definitely appreciate all the suggestions too. Even if we didn't get to yours, I wanted to so badly.
Yeah. Maybe we
especially
can do this
whoever
again.
Said, we would love to
we
do it
do
again.
We should do it again on just a Friday. We're just.
That'd be great when we're just chilling out. We got to have somebody. The key is we got to get somebody that's actually good at drawing instead of the two of us, like Mike Shinoda, because we are not good at this.
I know. Yeah. It's like, oh, haha, yeah, cute. But then, you know, after a few times, it's like, okay, these people really can't draw.
Like, right, yeah. Well. We're talking like first grade on my mom's fridge kind
but,
of stuff.
Okay,
over
John
here.
Did it with his left hand. Anyone who missed you. Earlier, thank you all. Official oh. Kasha and Vertigo, thank you.
Oh,
John
thanks.
Drew with his left hand, and they still looked good. So, especially
thank you.
Pikachu.
Thank right. you so much.
I got them all ready.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, let's
go
some
through
of these submissions.
And,
oh,
so chat, exciting. Y'all did a great job. So, we saw that first one. So I just want to make sure because I don't have that one up here, but I have all the other ones. So we saw that fat Pikachu, which was great.
Oh my God. Goodness. Look at the chunky little Pikachu. Chonky boy.
Oh, this is so cute. Oh my gosh, yeah. He looks like my old cat.
Oh,
oh
my God.
Gosh.
Yeah, he looks like he's coming up to you being like, is feeding time?
Yeah.
Oh my
goodness.
God.
Yeah.
So cute.
This
oh, nice. A little more like a more burnt Pikachu. Very
like
good.
That, yeah.
Like a fire type Pikachu. Oh my God. From Garbage? Garby underscore ch.
Garby tech.
It looks great though.
And then we got this one.
Love that.
Janae Nicole.
Oh, yeah.
With the Rolling Stone logo.
Hey.
Oh, that's great.
Backwards
hat. Oh my gosh.
So cute.
Oh, these are so cute.
All right.
Who do we have next?
My Shinoda.
Oh, my Shinoda.
Okay, that piece of sushi on the right looks really tasty.
Oh, wow.
They saw your sign behind you.
Yeah, honestly. I know. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
Oh,
and
God.
Then we got this one from.
Oh my
Angel
God.
Angel B12.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Angel B12. Goodness.
Oh, wow. Oh my God. It looks like a little cloud and it's
yeah,
even like a,
and
has
delicious.
A silhouette on the bottom.
The hair's got a little wave to it.
Yeah. Wow.
Then this is from Mariah.
Oh my goodness. Mariah.
We're all like, oh my God, so cute. I know, Tia, like, you're so like, look, I could eat that right now.
This taco sushi, everyone's photo, I'm like, that looks delicious. Great job.
And then here's the, hey, Cupcake sent us two. So here's the second one.
Oh my God.
She also did the chonky Pikachu.
What a chonk boy. Oh my God. We know her style.
Oh my goodness. Yeah, you guys drew some really good photos in a very short period of time.
Oh my God.
And this one's from Kosha.
Love that. Oh my God.
It's a little mouth and some eyes and eyebrows.
Well, y'all, stick around for a little bit because we're going to be chatting a little more. But right now, we're actually going to run an ad break.
Yes.
And if you're not subscribed to the Rolling Stone Twitch channel, we would love for you to do so. We do more fun activities like this all the time with more great guests.
Yes, we are. And so I just started vibing to the music. Like,
now that I know what this song is, I can never get it out of my head. It's like the Jackbox end credit song. That's what it is. It's like,
Got a couple more submissions that we can show off.
Oh, we got some more submissions. We're going to show them off during the break.
Yeah, yeah. We'll wait until when we're back.
Oh, but that one's great.
Oh, that is so cute.
Oh, yeah, I guess, yeah.
So cute.
Oh, my goodness.
I mean, what a talent. I love the Rolling Stone shirt. Oh, my God.